every single one of us, the devil inside.
Hey folks, Crazy Climber 80 here again, and it's time we're going to look at game number 8 in our 20 from 1988 series. And this was a blockbuster film from the previous year that was made into an arcade game. It was very, very successful and very cool. And this is Robocop. This was created by Data East and Ocean Software. Licensed to Ocean Software. Really created by Data East. But this is really well done. You have an 8-way joystick. You have a jump button. And you have a fire button. And as in the movie, the main hero is Alex Murphy, who was murdered by a bunch of drug dealers, cop killers, and turned into a robot.
Uphold the law.
There are a lot of cool touches in this game. Data East did a really good job with this. You have a standard gun that has unlimited bullets. And you can acquire new weapons along the way. Actually, to start the game, you don't have a weapon. You will eventually be able to withdraw it from your side holster. But to start with, you punch enemies. And I love how they included some good voice samples, like, drop it. But enemies... enemies from the movie make an appearance in this, at least. The fodder enemies, they kind of look like one of the bad guys from the film. And there's like a whole bunch of them, you know, copycats of them that are just throughout the game. There are enemies that will shoot at you. There are enemies that will throw grenades. There's all sorts of other dangers.
Serve the public trust, protect the innocent, uphold the law.
I really, really loved this when it came out. And I started seeing this at pretty much every arcade I went to. The backstory flies by real quick. You don't have time to read it. But, like I said, you start out just punching enemies. And you have a limited amount of life. You have a life bar below you that's blue, and it starts to get chipped away as enemies either run into you or shoot you. Even as a tough robot cop, you still get hurt when enemies run into you, which sucks. Be very, very, very careful with your footing in this game. You need to just inch forward enough so that you can shoot an enemy and then back off sometimes. Just one bullet will be enough to start chipping away your energy. There's some opportunities to get your energy back. Sometimes there will be jars of baby food, and sometimes they can appear from coming up close to those boxes and punching them. Sometimes you can get powered up weapons and shoot the boxes apart from afar. But, another possibility of getting your energy back is doing really well at target practice, which is a bonus stage that you get to play twice in the game. And you have to at least get really, really close to 100% to be able to get all your energy back and then possibly some maximum energy increase. And the first boss is Ed-209 from the movie. When he gets real close, he might shoot downwards, which will likely miss you.
Thank you for
such
your
great sound effects and dialogue kept from the movie. But there are a total of 7 levels, I think it is. Yeah, you will go through Main Street, Old Town, a junkyard, a narcotics factory, Omni headquarters. Sometimes there will be a guy that is holding a hostage. It is very unlikely that you're going to accidentally shoot the hostage, but I think you have to duck and shoot a lot to be able to kill them. I don't know that there's any penalty for doing so. I think you maybe get more points if you save the hostage. And now here's one of the power-ups. It is a double shot. And that guy with the chainsaw can cause a lot of damage if he gets close. So you want to try to shoot him enough from far away to keep him from getting close to you. And powered-up weapons can really help in that regard. Those enemies fly really far down if you shoot them from when they're high above you. Some doorways will have multiple enemies coming out one after another. There's another guy holding a hostage. With a powered-up weapon, you're likely going to take out the enemy real quick before you have a chance to kill the hostage. You have to plug the hostage with a whole bunch of bullets. But we will see me do that later. There is a three-way shot. There is a two-way laser. Those motorcycle enemies, oftentimes you'll need to duck before you face them, or as they appear, because they will try to jump above you. And if you just run into them, they'll hurt you pretty bad. Ouch, like that. And now this boss is a van arrest. Full of enemies.
You are under arrest.
And you want to try to take out, if possible, see if you can take out the guys on top. Waste the van, and then waste all the enemies that are coming out. And again, try to destroy those chainsaw guys before they can get close. Once you run out of bullets for your special weapon, and they are limited, I think they have like 30 for most weapons, and then some of the really strong ones are less. Once they are out, you are back to your rifle, your regular gun. And here is target practice. Just try to take out as many targets as you can real quick. They will appear in windows. They will appear as little bots on the floor. They will appear from the ceiling. And just keep shooting. Don't stop shooting. Just move the crosshairs to where the targets are. Try to get as close to 100% as you can. And you'll get a lot of your energy back if you do. And if you get it at least really close to 100% by the time runs out, then you might get your energy meter extended, the maximum extended, but I'm just going to get it refilled. I think you have to hit like 97 or 98% or something at least to get your max up. And now we're in the junkyard. Things get really tough now with enemies shooting at you from far away and just making a big old hail of bullets. Do not get trapped under that. If you get squished, you will die right away. That big old log that falls down, I don't know where the hell it's coming from, but it can cause massive damage if you let it. And there is a jar of baby food that will replenish my energy on top of that crusher there. Notice that the enemies never drop it. And here is my opportunity to get the Cobra gun, and this is badass. This was seen in the movie. This can take out those crushers, see? It can also take out those big old logs. When you are close to an enemy and you have a weapon, you will punch them, which is kind of nice. It conserves ammo. I love that the Cobra gun will take out that stupid chainsaw guy. This is a lift here, too. Doesn't really look like it. You can control that lift and go over here and get, I think that gives you energy back. Or maybe maxes out your energy. I don't remember for sure. But it doesn't give you a different weapon.
You are under arrest.
Yeah, that was kind of in the movie, but it wasn't a big burly guy. It was some guy that had just raped her and used her as a human shield while Robocop was coming to deliver justice and shoots the guy in the dick. And now we are attacked by pincer machines. I don't know what the hell you would call these. Back off and take out one, and then go back the other way quickly. You can get grabbed by that pincer and get some damage dealt to you, so don't let that happen. Yeah, I really love this. I love the movie. I still do.
Thank you for your cooperation.
It's got dark humor down pat perfectly. It's such a fantastic movie. And this is supposed to be Clarence Boddicker, though he doesn't really look like him. And he has him take him to the corrupt assistant head of the OCP Corporation.
Coming.
And in this area, I don't know where the hell those logs came from in a drug warehouse. In this area, when you need to scale or descend stairs, hold up and the direction of the stairs, or down and the direction of the stairs if you're descending them, before you get to those stairs. Note that there's some serious slowdown when there's an overload of sprites or bullets. But I died, and I get to put in my initials. There's no extra lives; you only get one. And when you run out of energy, you are prompted to continue. And if you choose to continue, you will lose all your score, but you will continue right where you left off. And I will do that later on. I mean, I just wanted to put in my initials. And you only get three, but all the other names in the high score list have more than three initials. That's not fair.
Serve the public trust, protect the innocent, uphold the law.
Yeah, that was in the movie, too. Just a really well-done game. I really enjoyed this. Well, we're going to continue now. I'm not going to do a full playthrough the rest of the way. That would take longer than I want to spend. So we'll just look at me having infinite energy and playing through the rest of the game. Whoops. Yeah, hold up and the direction of the stairs, if you're going up the stairs, before you get there. And you will walk with your weapon at an angle, and then you'll go up the stairs. Here, if you get trapped by those crushers, wiggle the joystick left and right and mash the buttons, and you'll be able to push them apart and break them. And yeah, you have to drop down through that broken stairway. Ah, the Cobra gun. Yeah, just one big old blast will cut through enemies and obstacles, and it's so nice to have. There is a cheat in MAME that allows you to permanently have the Cobra gun. It's pretty nice. Yeah, if you have a strong enough weapon, you can blow up those pressers before they can trap you. Yeah, never underestimate the power of that chainsaw guy. Don't engage him close up. Waste him from far away. And there will be barrels sometimes, not just crates, that you'll need to get close to and punch.
You are under
arrest. Yeah, like I was saying, I wasted the hostage. But yeah, you can accidentally waste the hostage, but it's hard to do. We will see me later on wasting the hostage. And this time we have a wrecking ball. And you gotta watch out, because here and there it will swing long, like there. And don't get close up to it, because even touching not the wrecking ball itself, but the vehicle or whatever will hurt you. If an enemy is shooting a boss and you destroy it, its shots will disappear so they can't reach you, which is kind of nice. But there are two target practices. And here's the second one. I didn't do nearly as well this time. I used to be okay at this part. I think I'd gotten like 97 or 98. I'll show you later on what it looks like to get 100%. I cheated to get there. I was better at this back in the day. I've had some times in recent years where I wasn't too bad at this, but I don't know that I was ever able to get 100% without like using save states or something. Yeah, you're just timed. If you get 100%, then you will definitely get a max up on your energy meter. And with infinite energy cheat on, the meter kind of looks janky at times. It looks way too long, I think. I don't think it's really that long in the arcade game. Or on the arcade cabinet. We are outside of Omni headquarters, and there will be lasers, there will be these drill things that stick out of the floor. And if you don't have a powerful weapon to destroy them, then you need to just time when you're going through. Oh, look at all these guys freaking taking shots at me. And yeah, we have slowdown here, major slowdown. There are also guys in jetpacks. I don't remember that being in the movie. If you've never seen Robocop, seriously, unless you're a complete prude and can't stand violence, and it is an incredibly violent movie, but if you can't stand that and you have no capacity for dark humor, then stay away from it. Otherwise, it's a great frickin' movie. It's a good idea, and we have Ed 209 again, but he's much stronger this time. He has major firepower, and he has these little missiles that he shoots. Make sure that you take out any other guys before taking on a boss, because they can still fire at you.
Thank you for your cooperation.
This guy is still flying around. At any rate, now we go inside Omni or OCP headquarters or whatever. This is seven floors, and there's more walls to punch through. That sucks that the cannons on higher floors can shoot through the floor to get to you, but you could do the same to them. These lasers, you cannot destroy them without a weapon power-up, and you might need the Cobra gun. Yeah, having the Cobra gun is really nice. And I think with the Cobra gun you only get 15 shots. With the other weapon power-ups, you get, I think 30 shots? And of course with your regular gun you have infinite shots. And I hear Ed 209. There are two of them. As with any game in which you have two bosses, try to take out one as quickly as you can. That way you have more room to move around and face the other one. Yeah, Dead Ace did a great job with this game. Just great sound effects and dialogue from the movie. Yeah, it was a fantastic movie. It really, 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 really put Peter Weller on the map.
Thank you for your cooperation.
And he'd always been a good actor, but he really, really stood out with Robocop, I think. People did recognize him from Adventures of Buckaroo Banzai, which I really didn't think was that great. A lot of people liked it, but I thought it was kind of a disappointment. RoboCop, why do you bother saying drop it? You know they're not going to drop it. In at the far left or far right, there may be some weapon power-ups or some baby food to give you energy back. And then we are just about to take on Dick Jones. And it's like a hostage situation. He's holding the president of OCP, and you just need to get a shot through and take out Dick Jones. It's not hard to do. I haven't been able to kill the president. I don't know that you can, but you don't get the opportunity yet. You have to destroy a very souped up Ed-209 who shoots homing missiles as well this time. But screw you, buddy, I got invincibility cheat on. I did not realize, I think, that I had run out of my weapon power-up, so I was trying to shoot just one shot at a time, which is all you can shoot with the double laser. And now we've got to take care of
the public trust, protect the innocent, uphold
Dick Jones. And there he's dead.
Thank you for your cooperation.
This game would have been, I think, a lot better if all the gore from the movie was in this game. That would have been fantastic. Seeing Emil, whatever his name is, the guy that got drenched with toxic waste and his skin was melting off. That would be cool to see in this. Blow your opponents apart with your gun or whatever weapon you pick up. But that was RoboCop, created by Data East and also licensed to Ocean Software. And Ocean got the rights from Orion Pictures. And so they got their name on the cabinet along with Data East. But it was created by Data East. There are a bunch of home console spin-offs. But that is RoboCop, created in 1988, and the movie, blockbuster movie, was released the previous year. Go see it if you've never seen it. But we are also going to look at a couple other things. Perfect target practice. And what else was it? I think killing a hostage. Like I said, it's hard to do, but I think if you duck and shoot them repeatedly, you'll waste them. And here's the perfect target practice. Yeah, just don't miss any of the ones that you had a crack at, and you will get 100%, and you'll get maximum energy up. That looks janky because they had infinite energy cheat on. And we're also going to look at me wasting the hostage.
You are under arrest.
Sorry about that. Well, that was RoboCop, created in 1988 by Data East and Ocean Software. Game number 8 in R20 from 1988 series, and I hope to see you soon with game number 7. Bye-bye, folks.